Several weeks ago, we posted a review video of the OnePlus 45 watts liquid cooler. This is the most powerful phone cooler we've ever seen so far. So let's take it apart today to see how it works to keep a phone cooler. The packaging adopts OnePlus Red, and the logo is in the upper left corner. It can be divided into two parts connected by a red flat cable. Here is the box-shaped cooling pump. Those holes on the back can facilitate heat dissipation. You can press the button at the top to control output power. The round LED light can indicate the current working status, and the LED lights on the back show the output power. The smart clamp is inside the box. It adopts a matcha design. Tear off the protective film. It's suitable for mobile phones with a width between 70 to 86 mm. You can also click the upper corner to check the size of this cooler. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart. The first step is to remove the fixing screws at the bottom. There is a small input module connected by a flat cable. The USB-C connector, LED lights, and film are on the other side. After removing the outer case, we can see the big fan and several water pipes. The red flat cable we just mentioned contains water pipes and other cables. And these are the cables connect to the main PCB, which controls the cooler. Take a close look at the front and back. Let's introduce all components of this PCBA module. The protocol chip is from SouthChip. It supports USB PD and dual DPDM interfaces, providing cost-effective solutions for many applications. The synchronous buck boost converter is also from SouthChip. It integrates 4 MOSFETs to provide high power efficiency and stable voltage regulation. The 3.3 microhenry L inductor is used to power the water pump with the converter. The synchronous buck controller is also from SouthChip. It can be used as a dual or single output. And the input voltage can be from 4.6 volts to 36 volts. The buck MOSFET is from High Semicon and adopts PDFN 3x3 package, 30 volts, 7.5 mA. This 4.7 microhenry LO inductor works with synchronous buck controller to power the TEC code plate. The synchronous buck converter is from Sology. It integrates MOSFET for the fast transient response. The Bluetooth SoC is from Jelly. It also has an external 24 MHz crystal oscillator. Here is the Bluetooth antenna. After introducing this PCBA module, let's remove the rest of the screws. This is the round LED light with an MCU to control it. The control button is on a separate small PCB. There are about 12 RGB LED lights on the front. The cooling fan is from Comdel. The size is 8020, 5 volts, 0.4 amp. Here is the radiator of the water cooling system. check out the water pump. It's a DC submersible pump from Jiayangchen. The rated power is 12 volts, 6 watts. The entire pump is wrapped with foam for buffering. Then use the spudger to pry along the gap to take apart the foam clamp. It's coated with pink thermal paste for better heat dissipation performance. Both springs on two sides can fix the foam tightly. The water pipe is fixed with glue. Continue to remove fixing screws and remove the back cover. There is a small PCB on the back. It's equipped with the 8-bit MCU from Chipsy. It integrates a 2K 16-bit memory and 12-bit high-performance ADC. Separate the TEC cold plate and water cooling block. They were also covered with pink thermal paste. There is an aluminum plate inside the water cooling block. We also take apart the cold plate. There are many small square blocks inside called PN junctions. It can cool on one side and heat on the other side, and conduct the heat from your fan to the water cooling block. Well, that's all components of this 45W phone cooler from OnePlus. To achieve a continuous and stable cooling effect for your phone, this cooler is a new attempt by the phone manufacturer. It combines water cooling and thermoelectric cooling. The TEC cold plate can lower the phone's temperature, and the water cooling can quickly dissipate the heat generated by TEC cold plate. Only this way can a better cooling effect be achieved on a limited contact surface. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!